Chopin's Nocturne in E minor was composed in 1827. This was Chopin's first Nocturne, but it was his 19th to be published. The composition features, and this is what I pulled from pulled online. This composition features an unbroken line of quaver triplets in the left hand set against a slow melody of minims, crotchets, quaver duplets, and triplets. It consists of 57 bars of common time with a tempo given as andante 69 beats per minute. The translation of that, it has triplets with the left hand. At the same time, the right hand is playing half notes or quarter notes, eighth notes, or triplets. And it's counted 4 beats to a measure, and the speed is not too fast. So they could have written it that way the first time. just a little side note with the Chopin. Many of you here knew a lady in this community by the name of Margaret Patmont. Margaret was unique in many ways. She was the type of person that you always knew where you stood at any moment. Margaret played the piano. Margaret loved Chopin. And she also loved the piano very much. She told everybody, "I have a Baldwin Anderson." And she'd had it for years. She took great care of this piano. Her daughter sometimes felt that the piano was treated better than they sometimes. But about a year and a half ago, Margaret and I were having a conversation, and she was had expressed some interest in selling her piano. She didn't think that she needed it anymore. And she said, "And I don't want to just sell it to anybody." She wanted it to have a good home. She didn't want it to sell it to somebody that had been neglected or destroyed or mishandled or abused. And so we talked about it for a while. And, what do you think I could get for it? And what do you think it's worth? And, do you know anybody that might be interested in it? Well, Ms. Schwartz expressed some interest in it. And I thought, that would be a good fit. And Margaret, I think, almost wanted to have an interview with you of purchasing this piano from her. So there was a Margaret decided that Anna could buy the piano, and so there was a price that was agreed. And the day that we met over to pick the piano up, Dad and Grunt and myself decided we were going to load this piano and load it. And so the day that we picked up the piano, there was a receipt ready for it and all that, the bill of sale. So the piano was loaded, and it wasn't too terrible to move, because it was a small spinet size piano. And Anna's father, Dave, got out his wallet to pay. And I told him that wasn't necessary. He said, "Well, yeah, well, we agreed with it." And I said, "Well, the plan all along was Martin was going to give the piano to him." So that's what happened. So the Chopin Nocturne, we're going to dedicate to Martin.